While various music genres have evolved around Europe, Bulgaria has its own unique blend. It's a land where two genres have been dominating. The first being Bulgarian pop folk music, also called chauga, and it sounds something like this. Just so you know, I don't really vibe with this type of music, I only dance to it to give you a demonstration. You can thank me later. The second one is trap music, and it sounds something like this. Yeah. Like many industries, Bulgaria's music scene faces tough challenges. The industry has since forever been bottlenecked by established artists and record labels. Artists with connections and influence often leave newcomers struggling for recognition by playing against them, messing with their work, or sabotaging them indirectly by blocking them from growing organically and profiting in the music genre they are interested in pursuing. Most record labels refuse to work with artists that have not yet made a name for themselves, and when they do, the contract conditions and support are not great. Artists that do embark on the creative process often find themselves working in isolation, exacerbating the existing divide within the music industry. Enter Dave Martin, whose story and work are a breath of fresh air in this competitive landscape. His journey led him to create a haven for artists. What was once a clothing shop has now transformed into a creative hub, where artists not only record, but also receive valuable coaching and singing lessons.
When you actually make it big, how do you plan on changing things around here?
Well, I would love to give artists more freedom, because I can see that the big labels right now are limiting and taking most of the profits from the artists. I would give them this freedom and let them be.
Just let them be, yeah.
Just let them be themselves, yeah. Also, I hope that tech one day will open doors for artists as well.
Yeah, stuff like the blockchain could do that probably. What type of beat was the last beat that you made?
Let me show you.
Okay.
Спрете земята, искам да слязам, а не спира да върти. Времето лети.
Dave's commitment to nurturing the next generation of artists is unwavering. As we chat with Dave, we reminisce about the time we collaborated on a rap song together. One of us, feeling tired, suggested grabbing a coffee. Almost unsurprisingly, that was me. So we jumped on a silver beast of a Mustang and rode to the beaches, a place called Wake Park, which is one of the most beautiful pieces of Varna. Here, we got ready to continue the interview in a much calmer setting. As we were sitting down, I couldn't help but feel grateful for being able to witness how beautiful Mother Nature is, especially during the golden hour.
Why is it that you do what you do? What made you want to do it?
Well, actually, it's a fun story. We weren't still living in Bulgaria, because I'm from Russia, and we came here on a vacation with my parents and my sister. At that time, my father was encouraging me to work out. So we went to the park around the hotel we were staying at, and I was doing a plank. I was 5 years old, it was a bit weird, but my father started to ask me what I want to do with my life.
At 5 years old?
Yeah, I was 5 years old. My father was like, what's the profession you, what's the path you want to go on? And I was like, okay, maybe music, because we had a piano at that time at home. And I was like, okay, I want to start with music, you know. And it was like, okay, but be a man. If you start something, you don't give up on it, you know. And I was like, okay, so yeah, that's when I decided I want to go on with music. and do that for the rest of my life. That was just like an imprint from my father, that a moment when I decided I want to do this for my life, for life.
Can you tell me about how you came up with the idea of helping local artists?
There was no teamwork between underground artists in Bulgaria. There was no team that could help out local artists. Everyone played by themselves instead of teaming together. We have many artists with different backgrounds and experiences here, and we're trying to build one united community.
Talking with Dave gives me an uplifting outlook on the future. Sadly, this documentary has to be short and it cannot cover all the nuances of the theme in depth. If you'd like to see Dave's work, you can check him out here. As for me, you can find me at Coco Online. And keep in mind, my shirts are the best. Ay caramba.io